Financial Bunny TV.
Hey guys, welcome to the Financial Bunny TV. My name is Nicolette Mashile, but you can call me the Financial Bunny. So today we're talking about the stock market. I get quite a lot of questions around what is the stock market? How does it work? How do I make money? Where do I even go for me to be able to invest in the stock market? And in actual fact, this stock market thing, who can invest in it? How does it actually make money? And what other platforms? I know I've just repeated exactly what I just said, but I'm excited because I just actually cracked something with one of my one-on-one clients in terms of explaining the stock market to her. Now, the one thing you need to remember is none of my videos constitute as financial advice. If you are looking for financial advice, please speak to somebody who is certified and registered with the FSCA, or preferably somebody who's got some sort of investment expertise, right? Because not all of us need to study to become financial advisors, but you do need somebody who definitely understands these things to be able to give you a proper investment plan. But when it comes to the education purposes, I got you. Nicolette's got you. Yes. So the one most important thing about investing, and I think it's important for us to start off with the concept of goal-based investing, which is something that I already explained in my previous video, right? Goal-based investing basically is, how do you make sure that the ways in which you want to invest, they are in line with what you want to achieve? So if your goal is financial freedom, what does financial freedom look like, and what do you need to invest in today so that in however many years where you want to now finally say, "Ooh, I've got financial freedom," this is what is going to get you to financial freedom. So basically, it's selecting the different types of cars that you are going to get into that are going to drive you to the journey called financial freedom, or the destination called financial freedom. But then you've got to define what financial freedom looks like for you, which then means that if that is your long-term goal, you've got to then say, what do I need to do in the midterm time that I've got to be able to get into the right car, so that right car can drive me? It's almost like relay. For those who do not know relay, your girl here used to run relay. And basically, relay is you've got a team of four people and they're passing on a baton to each other. And basically, the first one to be able to reach the finish line is the team that wins. But the beauty about relay is that sometimes it's a team goal that you guys are trying to achieve. Let's say it's a time that you're trying to achieve, right? So it's not always about the win. And even in finance, it might not always be about the win, or to be the first one to reach a certain financial freedom, but for you to reach that financial freedom in the little time that we all are awarded to when we are in this life thing, because we don't know when one is going to die, right? So it means that even when you do die, you want to make sure that the financial decisions that you're making today will still get you that financial freedom. It might not be for you, but it could essentially be for the people that you are currently taking care of. So let's talk a little bit about that. It means that there are different cars that you are getting into in the short term level, that you are driving into to take you to the midterm level. You gotta change cars and get into another one that then gets you to the long-term goal. You gotta drive into another car that will take you to the destination called financial freedom. So that's really important. But to be able to get into those cars, you need what is called a thingy, right? Let's talk a little bit about this. A couple of years ago, my boyfriend then and I went to the Maldives, right? Now, for us to get to the Maldives, you gotta take a flight from South Africa. You try and get into a flight that takes you to Qatar. Land at Doha Airport in Qatar, and then you gotta take another flight that takes you to Mali. When you arrive in Mali, you still gotta take another seaplane that takes you to Maldives, which is an actual island, right? So you can already see the different modes of transport that we need to be able to get into, right? In other words, you need to have a ticket for each and every single one of those cars. And now the ticket is based on where you actually started. So for me to be able to get, or for us to be able to get to Qatar, we needed a ticket that takes us from Oar Tambo to get us to Qatar. Then we needed another ticket, because you can't fly with the same ticket that took you from Oar Tambo to take you to Doha Airport. At Doha Airport, you need another ticket that takes you to Mali. Now in Mali, you need a ticket now for the seaplane to get you to the Maldives Island. That's basically how it works, right? That's life. But for you to start off with that first initial ticket, it means that you need to allocate a certain amount of money from your day-to-day budget, your monthly budget. Because now your monthly budget is going to get you that ticket from South Africa to Doha, to Doha Airport, which is now the short term. Now in the midterm, it's that flight ticket from now Doha Airport to Mali Airport. Now it's the midterm ticket. But you can't do the one without the other. right? If you've got a bottle of water, for you to be able to access this water, you need to be able to drink this water first. Now, of course, this is sanitizer. Please do not drink it. But I'm trying to explain to you that things move in sequence. It's sequential in English. So you've got to move like that in a sequential manner. So the first thing you've got to do is that in your monthly budget, you've got to allocate some funds to your investing. So when people ask me the question, what is the point of saving? I'm like, listen, you might not have short-term goals, but you've got long-term goals. And for you to get to your long-term goals, you got to make sure that the short-term decisions that you are making speak to the long-term goals. So for me to be able to get on a seaplane to take me to the Maldives island, I need to already start off by saying, what do I need to do in the interim to be able to get me to the Maldives island? So in other words, I need to make the right financial decisions so that I've got a ticket that takes me from South Africa to Doha Airport, right? So the decisions you make on a daily basis will count to what final destination that you actually make it to. A lot of people, because they don't plan for the final destination, end up being trapped in Doha, at Doha Airport, roaming up and down that airport, up and down that airport, because they don't have the next ticket to fly themselves to Mali, from Mali to the Maldives. Right, so very, very important. Let's go back to the stock market. So we've now established that you've got to save some money for you to be able to actually get. So remember that ticket that I spoke about. That ticket will then say to you, how much of something do you have access to? Yes, I might have access to the flight that takes me now from Or Tambo to Doha. But which seat am I sitting in? What am I getting while I'm sitting in that seat? What are the benefits of the seat that I'm able to buy? So if you have 300, you might be getting the economy class ticket, but you're getting to Doha. It doesn't matter even if you're in economy, but you could have R1,000 and that could get you to economy plus, as they call it. Or maybe you've got R3,000 that could get you into business class. Or you could have R5,000 that you can save, and that could essentially get you into first class on that same flight. And we know that the different classes, of course, have their different benefits, right? Now let's talk about the stock market. Now here you are, you've arrived in Doha. You now want to say, you know what? I want to now invest in the stock market. So take this as a company. So let's say this is Company X. Company X is listed on the stock exchange, which is called the Johannesburg Stock Exchange in South Africa. If you are in New York, it's called the New York Stock Exchange. If you are in Germany, it's called the Frankfurt Stock Exchange. So there are different stock exchanges for different markets, right? In South Africa, as I said, it's called the JSE, the Johannesburg Stock Exchange. Company X is listed on the Johannesburg Stock Exchange. This is Company X. Now, Company X wants to raise some money so that they can improve the company. When they improve or pay off some debt or expand the company or test out new innovations in the company. So what do? They then say, this white part of this bottle is what is going to be publicly put out for the public to be able to buy into Company X. So these are publicly listed, these are public shares that you and I can buy. Now with the ticket that you've got, whether it's R300, whether it's R1,000, whether it's R3,000 or R5,000, you can buy any part of the white part. So let's say you then decide that you are buying this part only, where my finger is. You buy that part. That is you now buying shares into this company. Now, what happens if the company does manage to sell this entire white part? The company could essentially now make a little bit more money. So what happens is the company's value expands. So the bottle expands. Now, that little part that you've got, when it expands, when the bottle expands or the company expands, your little part also expands. So that's how you make your money, because you could have spent R3,000 to be able to buy that little part. But as it expands, it could double up and you could now be sitting with R6,000 worth of shares. So you could have bought them at R3,000, but when the company expands, now your shares are worth, or your shares portfolio in this specific company is now worth R6,000. But of course, the market can do other things and the company might take a knock. For instance, right now, during COVID-19, during the lockdown, we've seen a lot of airline companies, because they are not trading right now, because aeroplanes are not in the air, the company is now shrinking in terms of its value. So your part that you have bought also shrinks. So all of a sudden, you're finding yourself for a share portfolio that you bought that was worth R3,000, all of a sudden now it's sitting at 1.5 because it's lost 50% of its value. Very important to understand, this is then not the time to be panicking. Because if you panic and you sell that that 3,000 rand worth of bought stock in that company, you now buying it and selling it at 1.5, you've essentially locked in the loss of 1,500, which is 50% of the stock that you had actually bought. But because you know that airlines will come back up and they will make their money because people will fly, borders will be open again. Now again, when the company does grow, your share of the stock market expands. But remember that it is not just you buying into individual shares. So you could essentially buy what is called ETFs, exchange traded funds. How do exchange traded funds work and how different are they from unit trust? When we talk about an exchange traded fund, basically what it is now let's talk about a salad. You've got a salad, right? In a salad, you've got different things. You've got avocados, you've got tomatoes, you've got feta, you've got bacon, you've got croutons. Ugh. Once croutons, you've got avocado, so you've got a mixed masala of different types of companies, for instance, in one salad bowl. How they are designed is dependent on the fund manager. Some of the indexes will be tracking maybe the top 40 on the Johannesburg Stock Exchange, and that would be the salad bowl. But the nice thing about an ETF, unlike a unit trust, it also performs as if it's one company, right? So you got a Capitec. But you can also get what is called an ETF that invests in the top 40 JSE listed companies that will behave the same way as an individual Capitec share. So it is also traded. You can buy it and invest into this salad of top 40 shares that are listed on the JSE as a share, as one thing. Right? Then when you talk about unit trust, it's again the same type of mixed masala salad, but now it does not behave as a share. It's simply a basket now of different types of small pieces of these companies. Small pieces of Standard Bank, small pieces of Capitec, small pieces of SAB, small pieces of Coca-Cola that are put into a unit trust basket. And your percentage of whatever it is that you have bought into this unit trust is how much you would then get back when you invest in this unit trust. So it is not active like an ETF or like an individual stock market or share or stock that you would get on a JSE. I hope that clarifies it for everybody. Remember that if you are a new person that is investing in the stock market, it probably is best for you to be able to diversify. When we talk about diversification, we're talking about you not putting all your eggs in one basket. So in other words, rather look at either the actively managed ETF, or you can look at the passively managed unit trust, which is just a salad. And you can mix masala in terms of your salad. So there are different ETFs that you can look at. I think South Africa's got over 1,300 registered ETFs that you can look into. It'll be different types of mixes. It could even be a property ETF that only has the companies in the salad. The companies that are in that salad are companies that are invested, or their core mandate is business. Or you could have technology stocks only in that ETF. So it's important for you to remember, but remember that is an actively managed type of in financial instrument. So that is how you make the difference, and that's how you invest in the stock market. Mwah! I love you guys.